we're on to our final speaker. It is my honor to introduce 16-year-old Helena Ikumi. You may recognize her from last year's rally or her amazing speech at the Tennis Providence event. She is the March for Our Lives Rhode Island co-founder, Rhode Island Youth Justice co-founder, and Rhode Island Women's Action Initiative Youth Representative. Let's give it up for Helena.
Everyone can hear me because last year I was too quiet for the mic and no one was able to hear me. Thank you. My name is Halima Ibrahim, but I'm also referred to as the Wake Up Girl. On this day last year, I read a poem in hopes that it would inspire you, some of you, to speak your truth and join our fight for a safer country. A year later, our fight still continues. I'd like to read a few words written by a Moroccan poet named Ahmed Bouanani. In one of his poems, he says, "I speak for those seated around me. If I said what I had to say to spring, she would dry up with rage. If I said it to the tree, he would lose all his leaves. If I said it to the rock, he would shake from side to side. All of you, you who have lived what my words account, listen to me. You have eaten the meat of a bitter fruit, and your children's lips are blistered." Ahmed Bouanani was 18 when Morocco regained independence from France in 1956. He was a revolutionary and a poet. He, more than anyone, understood what it was like to feel unheard, pushed aside. But he also understood the power of words. I believe in the power of our voices as a generation. We who have been born knowing pain, we have grown up knowing only of post 9/11 America. We were children alongside Sandy Hook. We have watched tragedy after tragedy, and we have witnessed as our world drowned in hate. But just because we haven't lived any other way doesn't mean we don't know different. We know peace and hope and love, and we know how to reach them. We know action. In regards to the recent tragedy at Maslow Nor in New Zealand last Friday, I will say our society is in dire need of change. We live in a time of fear and hatred. There is always someone trying to divide us, someone trying to turn us on each other. But how do we stop that? How do we stand together as one, supporting and caring for one another, regardless of all the pain? I will tell you now, it's going to take a lot more than thoughts and prayers. Shortly after last year's march, I wrote another poem, one that was incomplete and choppy. For months, it sat in the notes of my phone, forgotten, unread. Today, I intend to share that poem. I call it The Hero's Journey. Just a little heads up, there's a bit of call and response near the end, so. When you asked us what we wished for, we said world peace. When you asked us who we wanted to be when we grew up, we said the first female presidents. We said pirates and princesses and superheroes. Do not expect us to keep quiet while we watch our world be destroyed. Do not be surprised when we decide to make those dreams a reality. Do not be surprised when you stand up and fight. Do not be surprised when we call BS. The pirates are going to take back the nation. The superheroes are going to lead the world to peace. The princesses are going to rule. We are not the school shooting generation. We are not the Tide Pod generation. We are the revolutionaries. We rise up. We are the ones to scream wake up when our elders refuse to break out of their hibernations. When the adults cling on to ideas of a past, a time when the definition of beauty only meant white, blonde, and skinny, when fight like a girl was supposed to mean weak, or when little boy cried he was called a sissy, no longer shall your habits of hate be accepted. No longer shall we let another child look into the mirror and think they are not worthy of love. We are the definition of love. So yeah, we're the ones standing here with our fists raised high. We, the broken and the angry and the terrified, the beaten and the damned, the lost and the hungry, refuse to become the forgotten, refuse to become the hopeless, still beating. But who can say they won't stop tomorrow? Who says this isn't your final breath? So we stand here with our fists raised high, targets on our backs, despite the fear gnawing at our souls, despite the pain, the anger boiling our blood, despite the pain stabbing our heart, because who else will? Listen, I want everyone 19 and under to repeat this next part. We are Gen Z and we stand for change.
We are Gen Z and we stand for
equality.
We are Gen Z and we stand for equality.
We are Gen Z and we stand for peace.
We are Gen Z and we stand for peace.
We are Gen Z and we stand for hope.
We are Gen Z and we stand for hope.
We are Gen Z and we stand for love.
We are Gen Z and we stand for love.
We are the children who speak through blistered lips. Listen, for we have the power to rip down walls brick by brick. Listen, words are a tyrant's greatest fear, stronger than any bullet, bomb, or blade. Sure, you might think this is some charade, but no, we intend to continue this crusade until no child is left fearing that their life will end today. Listen, we are here, we are here, we are here. We are here, we are here, we are here. We are here, we are here, we are here, and we're not going anywhere. Because reality check, this world is ours as much as it is yours. Your turn to run it is almost up, and we're ready to play. And you bet we're here to win. Thank you.